Greetings, welcome to another edition. In this session, we'll be looking at the problem which is on the screen, which is the series of n factorial divided by n to the power of n. Our aim here is to determine if this series will converge or diverge. And obviously, our starting point will be to ask ourselves, which test should we use? Because we have a couple of tests that we can use to determine if a series diverges or converges, or in fact, in other cases, neither. So the first test, we have the ratio test, p-series test, comparison test, divergence test. There's many more, but for this video, we'll just think around these four here. So let's go to the next page and first start by establishing which test should we use. So looking at our problem here, it becomes apparent which test I am supposed to look. So I'm going to look there. If you look at this one here, I have a power of n. So what this means is that what we have is an exponential. So in other words, the way you are used to this is you would be saying you have an exponential function. And then another thing which I see here is that what I have here is a factorial function. And looking at these two, I need to remember something. When you look at your divergence and convergence test, you should note under which conditions are they applicable. So what I should remember is that for the ratio test, it is applicable when we have factorials and exponentials. So let's go ahead and define exactly what is the ratio test, because we have already to choose that it is what we should use, because the ratio test is applicable when we have factorials or and exponentials. So the ratio test, which is defined by L, is the limit of the absolute value of an plus 1 divided by an. And if you remember the ratio test, when the L is less than 1, the answer is this will converge. And when the L is greater than 1, this will diverge. And when we find out that our L is equal to 1, the ratio test unfortunately does not tell us much. So the answer is inconclusive. Okay, so let's have a look at our AN and then find our AN plus 1 and start doing our work. So if you look carefully, our AN is what we have above there, which is n factorial divided by n to the n. And our an plus 1, so wherever we see n, we'll go and put n plus 1. So that will be n plus 1 factorial divided by n plus 1 to the power of n plus 1. So if you look carefully, we'll have n plus 1 multiplied by n factorial divided by n plus 1 to the n multiplied by n plus 1. So now I can set up our L, which will be the limit as n approaches infinity. If you look carefully, I need to have an plus 1 divided by an. Here we typically put absolute values because you at times deal with complex functions. So in this case, it's just real functions. So I'm going to leave out that modulus there. So if you look carefully, I'm going to have an plus 1, which is n plus 1 factorial. Sorry, it is n plus 1 multiplied by n factorial divided by n plus 1 to the n plus 1. So I'm going to multiply by 1 over. Remember, when you divide by an, you are simply multiplying by 1 over an. So I can just have n factorial. So it's going to be n to the n divided by n factorial. And if you look carefully, n factorial and n factorial, they cancel. And n plus 1 and n plus 1, they cancel. So what we find ourselves having is n is the limit as n approaches infinity of n to the power of n divided by n plus 1 to the power of n. So when we look at our problem, we can see that we have a common power. If you look carefully, you have an n and an n. So it means that I can just make that power to be common. So I can just have n over n plus 1 all to the power of n. Now, we need to deal with this problem. And if you look carefully, once we have exponents, we want to introduce ln to drop down the exponential part. So let's just make a note. We will introduce ln to drop n, or the exponential part. So we introduce ln on the right-hand side and the left-hand side. So I'm going to have ln, others call it ln, which will be the limit as n approaches infinity of, if you look carefully, it will be ln of we have n over n plus 1 all to the power of n. Let's just make that to be a bit bigger. And there's something which I need you to remind you when it comes to the logs. So what I need you to remember is that when we have ln of a to the power of b, it is the same as b ln of a. So what this means is that our ln of l will be the limit as n approaches infinity of n ln of n divided by n plus 1, like that. So now we have a couple of ways we can deal with this problem. So I'm just going to attempt to make a few modifications here. So I'm going to rewrite this problem slightly differently. So n must approach infinity. So that ln there, what I'm going to do is I'm going to have n over, so that it becomes just easy to evaluate. I'm just going to have n over n plus 1. And this will be divided by 1 over n. So essentially, 1 over n still gets us back to exactly n. So when I now go and put in my infinity, what you will realize is that the answer will be, so when we put in infinity on the numerator, if you think carefully, so let me just quickly look at ln only. So if you look at the limit as n approaches infinity of ln of n over n plus 1, what you will be able to see is that you will find yourself having ln of infinity over infinity, which inside here gives you indeterminate form. And once you get an indeterminate form, you obviously want to find a way to deal with what is going on here. And there's a couple of ways we can go and do that. So if you look carefully, I can either say we have n over n plus 1. I can multiply the numerator by 1 over n, 1 over n. And if you look at what will happen, is that we will have ln of n divided by 1 plus 1 over n. So in fact, the numerator will just be 1. And if you look carefully, this, when we put in infinity, will simply be now ln of 1 over 1 plus 0, because 1 over n will approach 0 as n approaches infinity, which gives us ln of 1, of which ln of 1 we know that it is 0. Okay, so there we go. So this means that if we take in n as n approaches infinity, of that portion, this in fact approaches 0, so we have 0 there, divided by, we also know the denominator, that when you take in the limit as n approaches infinity of 1 over n, that approaches 0. So our denominator is also 0. So if you look carefully, that means that we have an indeterminate form when we look at our denominator there. When we look at the expression, I'll come and deal with this one a bit later. So I just wanted to show you how you could easily determine that this is indeterminate. So if you look at that, it is an indeterminate form. And when we get an indeterminate form, we have a couple of ways to deal about it. One of way is to just use L'Hopital's rule. So L'Hopital says, once you get 0 over 0 or infinity over infinity, derive the numerator and also derive the denominator. So this means that our ln of L will be the limit as n approaches infinity. We will derive the denominator, the numerator first, 1 over n plus 1. And we will also derive the denominator separately, which is just 1 over n. Then we will re-evaluate again this and see what we obtain. So let's go to the next page. So let me keep these notes on the previous page, so that in case you want to see how we got to that first indeterminate form, you can just zoom in and have a look at these notes. Okay, so let's deal with the second one here. This is what we need to evaluate. So if you look carefully, what we will have is the limit as n approaches infinity. So the derivative of ln of anything just becomes 1 over whatever that thing is. Then you should multiply by the derivative of what is inside the ln according to chain rule. Then divided by the derivative of that denominator is simply negative 1 over n squared, when you derive just 1 over n. So let's go ahead and finalize our derivation here. So we have the limit as n approaches infinity of, if you look carefully, that 1 over n plus 1 just becomes n plus 1 divided by n multiplied by, when I derive here, I'm going to use the quotient rule. According to the quotient rule, what we should do is we should derive the numerator, which is n. When I derive that, it will be 1, multiplied by the denominator. Then minus the numerator, which is n, multiplied by the derivative of the numerator, which will be 1. Then divided by the denominator all squared. That is what our quotient rule states, quotient rule of differentiation. Then here we just have negative 1 over n squared. So let's see if we can simplify this even further. So this will be the limit as n approaches infinity. So there's a cancellation of one of these here. This will cancel with one of those to leave a 1. And so that what we can have is simply 1 over n, open brackets, What is going on inside there? It's 1 plus n plus 1 minus n. And then this is divided by our n plus 1. So let me just put this way, just putting the n here. And this is all divided by negative 1 over n squared. Okay. So I can now attempt to simplify this even further by pushing that 1 over n squared up. So if you look carefully, what we will have is negative n squared when it comes up into those inside there will subtract each other. And then we'll be left with a 1 because this and that will cancel. Then we'll just have n squared plus n. That is what we have. So now this is the limit which we are evaluating. So ln of L is the limit as n approaches infinity of negative n squared divided by n squared plus n. There's a couple of ways which we can go about dealing with this part. But one way I'm going to choose is to just multiply by 1 over n squared. And what you do on the denominator, you should do on the numerator. So if you look carefully, we'll then have the limit as n approaches infinity of negative 1 over 1 plus 1 over n. And if you have a look at this, you'll have negative 1 over 1 plus. We know that as n approaches infinity, 1 over n will approach 0. So essentially, our answer becomes ln of L becomes negative 1. So therefore, the L which we were looking about for is just equal to e to the negative 1. And we know that e to the negative 1 will be just 1 over e. And we know that e is greater than 1. So therefore, if e is greater than 1, then 1 over e, which is equal to L, will be less than 1 in magnitude. So we can now conclude, because we can see that our L is less than 1. So our conclusion is that that series which we were given, n factorial divided by n to the n, it converges. Most importantly, according to our test, we should state that according to the ratio test. Okay, I hope this problem was clear and it helps your understanding of the concept. So make sure that you do practice L'Hopital's rule because it played a key part in getting this solution right. Most importantly, before we leave, make sure that you know that for the ratio test, it is applicable when we have factorials or and when we have exponentials. That is the secret to getting this problem correct.